And the objective for this lecture is to review the most common imaging features of heterogeneous lung. Why do I call it heterogeneous lung? Because sometimes the term mosaic perfusion gets a bit messy and confusing to many of radiologists. So I'll try to describe what we see in the mosaic attenuation lung. We'll review the causes of mosaic attenuation lung, and also we'll try to show you when we perform expiratory CTs. This is a normal inspiration CT. We see a rounded trachea, and this is an expiratory CT. We'll see the flattened posterior membrane of the trachea in an expiratory CT. When we perform an inspiratory CT, we see that there is an homogeneous lung. And when there's no air trapping, we see the same thing in the expiratory CT. When we describe heterogeneous lung attenuation, we have two main causes. The mosaic lung attenuation, that is mainly due to well-defined lobular and geographic areas. We see areas of diminished attenuation and areas of normal lung. We see some variation in vessel size. Here we see some vessels, and we see that there is vasoconstriction with diminished vascularity in a patient with air trapping. And when we look at the ground glass, the difference is that mainly it's ill-defined and there's no variation in vessel size. As we see in the CT, we can see areas of ground glass attenuation with some reticulation in a patient that has interstitial disease. The mosaic lung attenuation has two main causes, and we'll review both of them, but one is much more popular or common. That is the airway disease. So what do we see? Here we have an inspiratory CT and an expiratory CT. In the inspiratory CT, with this patchy areas of low and high attenuation, a mosaic lung attenuation pattern. Then when we perform the expiratory CT, we see areas of air trapping with diminished vascularity. What we have as a description is mild variation in vessel size. There is accentuation in expiration, as I just show you, and there's some airway thickening. In vascular disease, we see there's a marked variation in vessel size, as we see here, enlargement of the vessels, and there's no accentuation in expiration. We see the mosaic lung attenuation with areas of high attenuation and areas of low attenuation, and that persists with not that much change in the expiratory CT. Air trapping, that's one of the main causes of mosaic attenuation or air trapping in a patient with mosaic attenuation. When you perform the expiratory CT, you can find air trapping. And this is mainly due to obliterate bronchiolitis, bronchial obstruction, large airways disease, or obstruction. The main causes of air trapping are lung transplant, bone marrow transplant, some collagen vascular diseases, inhalation, infection, some rare diseases, and you can also find HP, as it was mentioned before in this series of lectures, respiratory bronchiolitis, asthma, and bronchiectasis. Small airway disease or bronchiolitis is due to inflammation or fibrosis of the bronchi, usually centered in and around the membranous and respiratory bronchi. We need to focus in the indirect signs. Patients that have mosaic attenuation pattern, that when we perform the expiratory CTs, we see air trapping. The direct signs of small airway are due to bronchial wall thickening, bronchiolectasis, luminal bronchiolar impaction, just as tree bed or central lobular nodules. Here we have two main causes, direct signs and indirect signs. Direct signs in patients with cellular bronchiolitis, we see central lobular nodules with tree bed pattern in a patient with cellular bronchiolitis. This was due to an infection. And here we can see a patient with constrictive bronchiolitis with areas of diminished attenuation, with vasoconstriction and diminished vascularity and areas of collapsed normal lung. The main causes, as I mentioned before, are lung transplant, bone marrow transplant, collagen vascular disease, inhalation, infection, and neuroendocrine cell hyperplasia. I'm going to show you some examples of all these entities, and let's start with Sewer-James-McLeod syndrome, where we see in expiratory CT, low attenuation lung with, we don't see that many bronchioles, and we can also see not that many vessels. When we perform the expiratory CTs, we see these areas of air trapping, and in the left lung, we see this normal lung with some areas of diminished attenuation or low attenuation that in the expiratory CT are mainly areas of air trapping, and areas of normal lung that it's mainly a bit more collapse. Post-infectious disease, like in this case, sometimes you can see settled areas of mosaic attenuation. You see normal lung and some areas of low attenuation. In those cases, we perform expiratory CT and we can see areas of air trapping mainly in the right lung and some small areas of air trapping in the left lung. This is a very interesting case, a patient that went post-lung transplant. The patient went to her pneumonologist, and as she had the history of lung transplant, she did some functional studies, and she read that she had the values, the FEV1 reduced. So they performed inspiratory and expiratory CT. The inspiratory CT, we see that there's not that many changes, some subtle areas of mosaic attenuation. And when we perform the expiratory CT, we see that's areas of air trapping and normal lung due to a chronic post-transplant rejection. This is a coronal view showing the same areas with air trapping in both lungs, air trapping and normal lung in some coronal views. It's another case. This was a patient that had a post-smoke inhalation air trapping disease. We see the mosaic attenuation pattern with areas of high attenuation and areas of air trapping, mainly seen in a patient that was exposed to fire in a closed environment. Rheumatoid arthritis, we always perform expiratory CT in patients with rheumatoid arthritis and Sjogren, as both entities can manifest with bronchiolar, bronchial disease and also with constrictive bronchiolitis. In this case, there's a slightly normal coronal view in the inspiration, and when we perform expiration, we see those areas of air trapping with areas of normal lung in a patient with rheumatoid arthritis. Another case that we have a rheumatoid arthritis, a patient with some subtle mosaic attenuation pattern, areas of high and low attenuation. And when we perform the expiratory CT, we see the areas of air trapping with diminished vascularity. And also we can see that tracheobronchomalacia in a patient with rheumatoid arthritis. This was the inspiratory CT, and we see the reduction in the area of the trachea in a patient with tracheobronchomalacia. This is a much more interesting case of rheumatoid arthritis because we have both bronchial disease and small airway disease. So we can see in both lungs, in the inspiratory CT, we see bronchiectasis, bronchiolectasis, some distortion of the lung in the anterior zones of both upper lungs. And when we perform the expiratory CT, we see those areas of mosaic attenuation with high attenuation and air trapping in the context of that collagen vascular disorder. Another very interesting case, because we can see two findings that are usually not that common in rheumatoid arthritis. One is the nodules, subpleural nodules, rheumatoid nodules. And the patient was performed an expiratory CT, and we see the areas of air trapping with diminished vascularity and areas of normal lung that's more condensed or collapsed, in a patient with constricted bronchiolitis. And here we have a patient with Sjögren. We can also see in patients with Sjögren bronchial disease. You can see here bronchiectasis in the middle lung, bronchiectasis with some distortion, some traction bronchiectasis. And when we perform the respiratory CT, we see normal lung and some areas, small areas of air trapping. We can also see airway bronchial thickening in both lungs. Deep niche is a rare and mainly unknown disease that is due mainly for by neuroendocrine cells and usually seen in women. So in patients that you see women and that you see small nodules, like diffuse small nodules around the parenchyma, we perform expiratory CT, and in this patient we have the nodules, and the expiratory CT we see there's areas of normal lung and areas of air trapping with diminished vascularity due to deep niche. The bronchiolar obstruction can be due by hypersensitivity pneumonitis or respiratory bronchiolitis. It was mentioned before, I'm going to review some cases to show you this entity. Here is a case of non-fibrotic or inflammatory hypersensitivity pneumonitis with small ground glass centrilobular nodules. And we can see this, and we see areas of air trapping or mosaic attenuation, areas of normal lung and areas of diminished attenuation. And when we perform the expiratory CT, we see that area of air trapping. The inflammatory or non-fibrotic hypersensitivity pneumonitis usually resolve after you remove the antigen. This is a very interesting case, a patient that had 90 pigeons and recently brought into her house, and she had small ground glass nodules and some areas of mosaic attenuation with higher and low attenuation. And an expiratory CT was performed, and we can see those areas of air trapping, those areas of normal lung in a patient with non-fibrotic inflammatory hypersensitivity pneumonitis. We can see the small ground glass nodules and those areas of air trapping on the expiratory CT. Another case where you can see was exposed to duvet feathers, and we see diffuse ground glass opacities with areas of low attenuation pattern. Then the expiratory CT was performed, and we see that triangular area of air trapping with diminished vascularity in a patient that had also some ground glass opacities due to the entity and not just normal lung. This patient in June, he had that ground glass opacities, and the antigen was removed. And we can see that there is resolution of those ground glass opacities in this patient with hypersensitivity pneumonitis. We can also have patients that have fibrotic hypersensitivity pneumonitis, in this case where we can see that mosaic attenuation pattern with areas of high attenuation and areas of low attenuation, triangular. There's a progression, and there's some in the expiratory CT, we say that triangular area of air trapping. Usually the air trapping in patients with chronic or fibrotic HP are in the areas of normal lung and not in the areas of fibrotic lung. This is the case. We see the inspiration, inspiratory CT. We see areas of high attenuation and areas of low attenuation, very heterogeneous lung. We perform the respiratory CT, and we see that triangular shape, air trapping, some rounded air trapping. We see a traction bronchiectasis and some distortion of the lung in a patient with fibrotic HP. Asthma and bronchiectasis are causes of large airway disease. And here we have a patient with asthma, or you can see a very light mosaic attenuation pattern with some areas of ground glass opacities and some areas of normal lung. And when we perform the expiratory CT in these asthmatic patients, we can see perfectly the areas of air trapping, patchy air trapping, and areas of normal lung with some bronchial wall thickening. Here also to show you the patient with asthma, where we can see bronchial wall thickening. We don't see that mosaic attenuation pattern, but in patients with asthma, we perform low dose expiratory CT, and we can see that areas of air trapping with diminished vascularity in a patient with, this was a patient with severe asthma. Another patient with asthma and bronchiectasis, we see areas of low attenuation, thickening of the wall. Expiratory CT shows us the air trapping in a patient with asthma. Another cause of bronchiectasis and bronchiolectasis in air trapping, we can see cystic bronchiectasis in both lungs. And when we perform the expiratory CT, we do see those cystic bronchiectasis with areas of air trapping in a patient with large airway disease. Another cause that can show us mosaic attenuation is a patient with bronchiectasis, and mainly in the, but both lungs, but we can see the middle lung and the lingula, and we can see those areas of mosaic attenuation with patchy areas of high and low attenuation and small nodular centrolobular nodules in a patient with MAI and bronchiectasis. Just to start closing, we already covered the airway disease, and I'm going to show you a case of vascular disease. This is a patient we can see mosaic attenuation with areas of high attenuation and areas of low attenuation, but we see that there's much more vessels than we saw in the patients with airway disease. This patient had a thrombus, so he has a mosaic lung attenuation due to perfusion disease. And the patient had a chronic thromboembolic pulmonary hypertension. This patient, when we measured the pulmonary artery, had enlargement of the pulmonary artery. The patient had the, in the expiratory CT, we didn't see that much change in the vessels within the lung. It's important to mention that patients with chronic thromboembolic pulmonary hypertension have also vasoconstriction due to the first stage that's inflammatory, and then there's a vasoconstriction and you have enlarged proximal vessels with vasoconstriction, distal vasoconstriction. The patient was treated and we see that the areas that were had much more low attenuation start to have another change in opacity, and we see much more normal lung in a patient with chronic thromboembolic pulmonary hypertension. Just to finish, heterogeneous lung attenuation may be challenging. The most common causes are airway disease. Expiratory CT is essential for confident diagnosis, mainly to differentiate mosaic lung attenuation from mosaic lung perfusion. In the day-to-day challenge, we use expiratory CT mainly in cases that we know that had lung transplant, in some collagen vascular disease, in inhalation, and in asthma. And also in patients that we have suspicion of hypersensitivity pneumonitis. Those are the main studies that we perform low-dose expiratory CT that give us much more confidence in our diagnosis. Thank you very much.